Hello and welcome to CLI. Today we'll be exploring the fifth and the final platonic solid, that is the icosahedron. Such a magnificent structure, isn't it? Well, it's made up of 20 faces, with each face being a triangle. And if you notice, along each vertex we have 5 adjoining equilateral triangles. First, second, third, fourth and fifth. And the base of these triangles, they form a pentagon. If you see this vertex, you have these 5 triangles and the base represents a pentagon. Now let's explore the structure and find out its circumradius, in radius, volume and the dihedral angle. Now, since the structure is symmetrical from all sides, I've taken 2 opposite sides, the blue stick one and the opposite. As you can see, I've connected them with these straws, that is the green ones, and they form a rectangle. You can see in this figure very clearly. Now, if I join the diagonals of this rectangle, I can now find the center. Now, the circumradius of this structure is nothing but the distance between any of the vertex and the center, as you can see.
Now, if the side of this icosahedron is of unit length, then what would be the length of this rectangle? If you notice, these 5 points make a pentagon, and the green line is actually the diagonal of this pentagon. So, what would be its value? Well, it's nothing but the golden ratio. Now, to find out what exactly is golden ratio, please click on the above link. This golden ratio is denoted by the Greek alphabet phi.
Now, to find out the volume of this icosahedron, I have taken one triangular pyramid such that its base is exactly the face of the icosahedron. So if I fit this triangular pyramid inside the icosahedron, I find that the apex touches at exactly the center of the icosahedron. So if I have 20 of these, I find that they take up the entire volume of the icosahedron.